ambition.
Being a good practical worker.
They'd have to be hardworking.
Without a doubt, you have to be positive.
And you really need enthusiasm.
Committed.
Good team player as well.
And willingness.
I was always looking for apprenticeships since I left school.
It really stood out as something that I was interested in.
I just wanted to do something more practical.
I wanted something that would give me a future career that I could work towards.
I handed them an application form and they got back to me to invite me to a testing day.
They put you through an aptitude test. So you had English, maths, engineering and then a practical side.
If you were successful on that day, you got invited back for a second day for a more formal interview. I felt like the interview had gone quite well.
When I got the call, I was over the moon. I couldn't believe, you know, SGN took me on.
SGN is vital that we have apprenticeship schemes. The job we do is the gas emergency service, so it's crucial that we have a highly trained, highly skilled, efficient workforce.
We mix about a bit, but we get to learn on site and also in the classroom, so we've always got a varied side there.
The job I first applied for was a depot apprentice, and that's more multi-skilled, whereas I'm just specifically electrical and instrumentation maintenance. The apprenticeship is very tailor-made to that job, it's very specific.
We go out on site and work with trained technicians, and we also go to college and learn the basics behind it.
During the apprenticeship, you learn so many different skills. I like to teach you in the whole aspect of the business because that is what the company needs.
Yeah, I definitely think it's beneficial to be at college and then straight away applying it to the work situation.
You get to keep your skill base, your practical side and your theory at the same level.
At college, they learn the skills they need to do the job. In the field, they learn the practical skills, and to have a mentor there to ensure that that person's got guidance along the way is crucial.
Mentors are there to help you along. If you've got any problems, say academically, or if you've got a problem out on site, then you can go to them for help. I wouldn't know any of the stuff I know now without them.
SGN as a company is very supportive to work for. The management team support you very well, and all your colleagues really, they're all very happy to help.
Mentors are vital for, you know, the apprentices at SGN, and to know that there's someone there to help you is invaluable. Really.
Not just offering an apprenticeship where people come into the business to become an engineer and see that as the job for forever and a day, we're actually offering career progression as well, so people can see the steps that they need to take to become an engineer, but they can then see beyond that.
Well, I knew that it would take me into a promising career, and there would always be scope for movement as far as I could see.
I think SGN gives you the opportunity to progress within the company and, you know, take that step into management if you want to, yeah.
I'll hopefully qualify through my apprenticeship, get authorised and become a trained technician, then maybe become a senior technician.
I don't want to stand still. I'd like to move on through the company and eventually be a manager at a higher level.
SGN apprentices are absolutely crucial. I can say that because I started life as an apprentice 23 years ago, and SGN and the industry has given me a very good career. I believe that apprentices can often be the catalyst to change within the business. It allows us to move with the times and keep the business moving forward all the time.
The best thing for working for SGN is without a doubt the people.
Kind of community of workers working together.
It's a good opportunity, especially on the apprenticeship, to have a long career in the industry.
I really do enjoy coming to my work, and I'm really glad that it's worked out the way it has.